Pop, get him. Get him, Ragnar. Let's see what you got. All right, survivors of the Pink Sheep Clan. Pop quiz for you. Let's say you're down in a hole. You found a lovely ravine, but you only had time to explore maybe half of it. Your food supply is running dangerously low. You're only down to 5 steakums left. Your torch supply is running low too, and you don't have much wood to make more torches, or tools, or weapons for that matter. In fact, your Viking axe is about to break, and your shield's about to pop, and you're surrounded by enemies on all sides. That's why they call it surrounded. What do you do? Do you run screaming to the surface like a baby? Or do you stick around and explore the rest of that ravine for more of these blue things right here that I found out? Well, hold on, wait, what did I do? Stop. These things right here. You stay, right? Yes, of course you do! True survivor, that's what I wanted to hear. Now give me those back. Give me that stuff back. Let's get back down to that ravine, my friends. We have more work to do. We're not done. But we're not going to spend much time down here. I know you guys want to get back to do some other things, and so do I. But we have a few important tasks to do down here, and I will explain as we meander down this way, as we saunter like a true Viking warrior of the Pink Sheep Clan. All right, let's get back down here. I want to go get some obsidian. We have this diamond pickaxe now. But we only have 3 diamonds left, unfortunately, so we're going to be on the lookout for more diamonds. I really want more. Now, we can use those 2 to make we can make an enchantment table, but we can't really do much enchanting. Actually, we can't do any enchanting, really, without lapis. So we will be on the lookout for good old useless lazuli. Oh, gosh, guys. You guys are in a rough spot up there. You can't go up, can't go down. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when somebody shoots you in the back? Nothing. Nothing you can do except take it. Like a good zombie should. Alright, let's put up a sign here. This is one of the things I want to do, is leave the... remember, recording history here. Found first... Whoops. Found first diamonds, episode number 5, March 8th, 2016, rather. So there. History has been recorded, and now we can move on and continue with our Minecraft story. And remind me, when we get back home, I need to write down in my journal about these diamonds. And also the pink sheep that we found, the sacred pink sheep. We need to leave a sign there, too. But first things first, my friends, we need to grab some of this obsidian. We're going to need 4 for an enchantment table. And we're going to preserve some of those diamonds for an enchantment table. But it would be lovely if I could find a few more. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take a right. My right. To that right, over there, that way. And go investigate the rest of this ravine, because there's lots more down there. And we're gonna name this place Diamond Ravine, because I bet there's more. I can smell them, can't you? All right, 5 total obsidian, perfect. I got 1 extra, just in case. Okay, now, I'm gonna be also on the lookout for some more iron so we can make an anvil. A dungeon would be awesome as well, if we could locate a dungeon. I'd like to get a saddle. So here's what we're gonna do. Let's just go this way. Ooh, here we go. I could just pour water out all over the lava and make a safe path that way, but I really don't like to destroy the natural occurring terrain. I like to leave it as organic as possible. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I do have a bucket of water here, but yeah, I like to leave it. I like to leave nature alone if I can. Let's grab some redstone. I'm not planning on making any redstone contraptions anytime soon, but what the heck, we get experience for it, right? Might as well. Alright, awesome. So I'm gonna try to do this as quickly as possible. Let's just bust through here. Ooh, more redstone. And keep our eyes open for what we desire. Lapis, iron, redstone, etc. And I think I might just do most of this off camera, because you guys don't want to see this again, since we just did this a little while ago. But if I find anything interesting, you guys will be the first to know. If anything really funny happens, I'll try to catch it on camera. I'll record the whole thing, of course, and if I die in a blazing glory of lava, then I know you guys will want to see that, so. Oh, I lost that piece. Okay, plenty more. And then once we're done here, we're going to head to the surface And we're going to go on a Viking raid. We're going to take our longboat and maybe go look for a village. We'll take it right along the shoreline. I'm not sure which direction yet, but we'll see if we can find a village that we can raid and steal their food. Maybe find a blacksmith shop. Okay, busted through behind this waterfall here. Let's go and see what we find. Oh, there's gold and a burning bat. It's a common sight here. I don't see any more diamonds nor lapis, which is kind of a stinker. Let's make a path right here. A path! And see what we can see on the exterior of all these walls. And oh my gosh! No, you don't. That's right, you deserve that. Try to shoot me into the lava, will ya? Woo! That was close. I was in panic mode for a second. Alright, almost to the other side. Very dangerous crossing these bridges here, and uh-oh, I'm starting to get hungry. I'm gonna have to dig into some of my low food supply here. We've got iron, lots of coal, burning bats, and gold. I'll grab the gold. Got a bit of gold here. Let's go grab that. Oh! Holy mackerel! Hold the phone! Guys, diamonds right here in front of me in my path. And that's not gravel. Oh, excellent. Oh, another one. That is gravel. Man, they all look... The gravel looks the same to me, dang it. Alright, there's this marble, whatever the heck it is. Alright, we got some diamonds here, guys. Awesome. One, two, three. And make sure you catch that one. Four, five, six. Nice! Six diamonds, and I want to grab that gold, too. Oh, what's this over here? Oh, lapis! Lapis lazuli! Awesome. You know what? I'm gonna just bust right through here. First lapis. How lovely. And we are through. More gold. Ooh, we're kind of off the beaten path now. This is not really the ravine, technically. Well, maybe so. Oh, look. There's more right there, too. Awesome. Alright, here we go. Our first lapis lazuli. Not really worthy of a sign. Although I will stop calling it useless lazuli, so there's something, right? And look at this room here. What do we got? Oh, it opens up big. Okay, let's do this so we know which way to go out. Grab the lapis. And ooh, there's some more. And we need this for enchantment. Enchantment? Enchantment! Oh, guys, look what I just found. Another ravine. Maybe it's a different wing of the same ravine. But, man, that looks so enticing. I can't do it. Can't do it! Just grab this and get out of here. Not gonna do it. Let's go. Okay, heading back now. Oh, hello! Fancy meeting you here in a dark alley. He was waiting for me. That was an ambush. You see that? Oh, another one. Bam. Slap. Spank. Alright, let me just grab this iron real quick. Okay, guys, swimming up the waterfall that got us down here in the first place, and I hear that sheep that tried to steal my longboat. There you are! You know, it's probably not the best idea to steal a longboat from a Viking, or at least try, and then just sit there like a fool. Not go anywhere. So, oh, gosh, let's go. All right, you're coming with me, fella. You don't have any choice. You've been sheep-napped. Let that be a lesson. Now, I wanted to just put a sign here. Isn't this where I found the first pink sheep right here? Oh, gosh. All right, this is dark and scary, dangerous wood. You know what? I'm going to have to go back and watch the video. Because I don't remember exactly where I found the sheep, but I think he was right here. I'm going to put a sign up. All right, come on, you're coming with me. No choice in the matter. I'm going to turn you into some mutton. You especially don't want to hop into a starving Viking's longboat if you're a sheep. Yeah, you're rethinking that now, aren't you? Well, let that be a lesson for you. You can stay right there and dwell on it. I'll be back for you. Whew. All right, we're back. Safe. Now, let's get this stuff cooking. All right, guys, welcome back. I am all reorganized, re-outfitted, and ready for our Viking raid in the longboat. But before we go, we got some important business to attend to, and that is to record our first diamonds, which I have not done yet. So let's catch up and put that in our journal. Found first diamonds, and that's definitely worth a shout. Diamonds like that, and there we go. Awesome! Let's put our diary here inside our footlocker. And you can see here in the footlocker I have all my most valuable possessions. My diamonds, redstone, gold, lapis, iron, obsidian, grass block, and of course the journal. And now I think we're ready to go. Oh, no, it's nighttime. I need to go to bed. Hold on. So here's what we're after on our Viking raid right now. We want to find food because we're running a little low on the food. And I need leather for an enchantment table. Nice shot. Nice. Oh, a hole. Not going down. Not going down. Stay away from the hole. I'd also like to find a companion. I need an Icelandic sheepdog. I need a sheepdog to protect the flock of sacred pink sheep. did I say leather? Yes. Maybe a village if we can find one. So I don't know how long this Viking tour is going to last. But it depends on how much of the footage underground that I show you guys. Because I was down there for a good 40-45 minutes, but that's too long for one episode. So let's just keep our eyes open for new stuff. Okay, that river right there is just going to lead back to where we found the pink sheep. So let's stick to the right here. And this is, of course, east toward the sun, the rising sun, which just came up. And again, I don't know how much I'm going to show of all this, because I need to cut it down to keep the episodes a good 20-25 minutes, which I think is about right. Oh! Wolves! A.K.A. dogs! Look at them all! We got a pack right here! Hey, guys! Hello! Stay right there. Coming for you. Oh my gosh, look at them all. It's a whole horde! Hello! Oh, are you pretty? Purdy, I mean strong and hardy and lean and mean, like a good Icelandic sheepdog should be. And you're not afraid of getting wet. That's important. And how about the cold? You mind the cold? No? Good, because we're going to be going to some cold temperatures areas too, my friends. So tell you what, come on out of there. Come on, come. You're good enough. Get the first one you see, as far as I'm concerned. One. Come on, have another bone. Whoa, two! And have a seat right here on the shore. Oh, I love him. Love him so much. But we gotta give him a name, right? And I don't know what name yet. I have some in my head, but I want to hear what you guys think. So put down in the comments, give me some names. I know, like I do a lot of Wilson. Oh, you're ready to go! Jumps right in the longboat. He's ready to go. Oh, you're a perfect Viking dog. Okay. Let's put the sign right here. I guess that's close enough. Whoop. Put it here in the on the sand. There we go. Tamed. Name here. Episode 6. March 10th, 2016. And since we don't know the name, we're just going to have to leave it like that until we give you a name. Okay, little buddy? I'm sorry. You just be nameless for a little bit. Now push over. I'm driving. Here we go. Look at all the other ones. So jealous. They all want to be a Viking pet, don't they? Oh well, it can be only one, at least for now. Chicken! Let's get him! Let's see. Oh, a creeper face down there. That was cool. Almost a creeper face. Let's get him! Dog! I think for now I'm just gonna call you Ragnar for now. Ragnar Lodbrok. Or Lothbrok, depending on how you say it. From the Vikings, the Viking show. Oh, well, well, come on, Wilson. I'm going to poke him, and I want to see what you can do. Hit him with a bone. Ready? What did I call you, Wilson? He's like, why'd you call me Wilson? Pop. Get him. Get him, Ragnar. Let's see what you got. Come on, take him down. Go get him faster. Oh, you're kind of slow. There we go, nice, get the pig. Get him, Ragnar, come on, true Viking attack. Ooh, lovely, I'll take the meat. Let's get this chicken too here. Pop. Okay, guys, we're running out of daylight, so I think we should get back on with our Viking reconnaissance expedition. But I want to try something with the boats, because you guys said that we can use boats on land. Oh, we sure can. Although it seems kind of cheaty. It's an exploit, and it most likely will be fixed, but that is pretty awesome. All right, anyway, back in the longboat, let's move on. I want to see what's down this river here that we spotted when we were slaughtering the bacon. I'm going to go right down this lane. Oh, good. I need that. Need this for paper so we can make books, so we can make our enchantment table. Oh, cows. I see cows. Leather. Perfect. And I'm going to grab these peonies too because I want them for my house because they're pink. I need the dye, and I want them to spruce up the garden out front and maybe the sacred pink sheep shrine when we get around to it. And here's some more sugarcane, and I can feel my stomach is ready to grumble any second right now because it is my lunch break and I'm starving. All right, let's get you out of the boat, and let's go see how you deal with cows. I'm gonna bonk him in the head with the bone as usual. Bonk. Oh, I missed. Bonk. Okay, get him, buddy. Get him, Wolfie. Get him. Oh, you jumped right over him. Oh, there's the leather that we need so much. And what do we get there? Do we get any more leather? Yeah, 3 leather. Perfect. All right, did we get them all? I guess so. Let's put some torches up here so we know that we've been this way. And it looks like the sun is about to drop, so let us get back in the boat and go a tiny bit further, and we'll turn around. But I want to see how far this thing goes. It's a river. Come on, buddy. Get in. Go on. Hop in the boat. Get in the back seat. Good. Oh, oh. Pumpkin. Awesome. Awesome. Oh, a village! We got a village! We got a village, Pooch! Woohoo! We can raid the village now. Awesome. But I don't want to do it right now. Let's just hide here. I don't want to give away my position. They're probably so cozy and comfy over there. Never been attacked by Vikings before. Probably very peaceful. But wait till tomorrow. I don't want to do it now. It's too dark. And I want to get back. And this episode's getting kind of long. All right, let's get back in the boat and head home, guys. I think this episode is complete. How much leather do I have, though? 3. That'll give us a few books. Yeah, that's okay. Let's get back home. I want to make up an enchantment table real quick. And then we'll call it quits. And I want you guys to give me some names down below in the description. Forget about it, Creeper. You can't catch me in my longboat. Oh, I love these river rides so much, guys. They're so fun. Especially now that we can bring our pets. Just putting torches on these sandbars so we don't smash into them. They're like little mini lighthouses. And I think we are home. Pretty close to it. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. Look at this. Archers on both sides. Shoot! You're gonna miss. Aw. I like it when they miss. It's fun. Wow. Look at them all out there. This place is overrun. We're going to have to do something about this pretty soon. All right, let's get you out of the boat. I'm going to need your help to get back home safe and sound. All right, let's make a run for it. Whoa! Get him, Pooch! Hey, don't hit my dog! Come on, I got some food for you back at home. We'll heal you right up. Welcome to the Pink Sheep Clan hidey hole, little fella. Whatever your name is. Come on. And come on inside and sit. I'm going to put this out front here. Keep the bad guys away. Maybe scare them a little. Okay. So let us make our enchantment table. Should be pretty straightforward. Hopefully I get this right. And I don't embarrass myself. I know it's been a long time, but there it is. Enchantment table! Woohoo! Enchanter! Enchantment? Enchantment! Let's put it down right here for now. Yeah, let's put it right there. Looks perfect. Okay, now scooch over. Scooch, scooch, scooch. You can go sit on that nice pink mat right there. And, oh man, there it is. So, I think what we're going to do is wait till the next episode before we do any enchanting. Because I'm not sure exactly what I want to do. Whoa, hey. You, get back over here. I think what I will do is make another book. And then enchant the book and just see what we get. Let's just try it right now. We might as well. What the heck, we came this far. So let's just do it. Let's make another book. Alright, just wanted to get the bacon cooking up in the micro. And now, it's time to do our first enchanting of 1.9. Here we go. Book. Lapis. Oh, it even shows you. I forgot. Sharpness. Oh, that's perfect. Let's just do a sharpness 1 for right now. I mean, it's cheap, right? Better than feather falling. Although, feather falling's pretty good, too. We can put that on a piece of armor. Let's go with the sharpness. I want to get this on my axe. I'm going to put that on an axe. I don't know if I want to put it on an iron axe or a diamond axe yet. But, man, I'm getting so sloppy with my materials. I don't know. I'm going to think on that. So we have the book at the very least. It's sharpness 1. But anyway, all right, I got to go. It's late. I'm hungry. I have not eaten lunch. And I gotta go. So we'll see you guys in the next episode. I hope you enjoyed. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.